Hello friends, as we are discussing our module 3, that is the evolution, so today the topic is too much interesting, that is the type of speciation. So basically in this module we are going to discuss what allopatric speciation and what sympatric speciation. Then after we will discuss about the comparative view of allopatric and sympatric speciation. So, what exactly the speciation is? Speciation is the evolutionary process by which reproductively isolated population evolve to become distinct species. There are four known methods of speciation, all of which have occurred naturally at some point. This is the time period and original population. This is the polymorphism occur. And here the reproductive isolation within the population. And here is the speciation. So, speciation, it is an evolutionary process by which reproductively isolated population evolve to become distinct species. As you can see in this diagram, this is the original population which is green in color, and this is the geographical barrier with respect to the time period. This is the reproductive isolation. This species is different and this species is different. Due to the reproductive isolation, two species will become formed. So, allopatric is what? Is population is split into two geographically isolated population. Allo means different geographical area and sim means same geographical area. So, due to the geographical change such as mountain formation, the isolated population then evolve different genotypes or the phenotypes as they both experience different selective pressure, independently undergo genetic drift and they have mutations occur. So, in one line you can say that allopatric speciation is the speciation which occurs at two different geographical area or which they are isolated by a geographical barrier. What about sympatric? New species arises from two or more descendants of a single ancestral species all occupying the same geographical location. What exactly occurs in sympatric? They are in the same geographical area. But due to reproductive isolation, they are not reproductively compatible. This is often seen when different groups of single species or insect all become dependent on different plant, eventually resulting in different species. So, allopatric speciation, it is the allo, this word is other, and Greek patris, that is the fatherland, means different geographical area. So, divergence of physically separated population of species occupied separate geographical area into two species. Yes, through this figure you can easily understand. This is the geographical barrier which is red in color and this is the species 1, this is the species 2. And here hybrid zone will appear. This is the hybrid zone where the species are mixing and this is the hybrid. Some hybrid will appear in the species 1 and in species 2. So, the type of speciation that occurs when the biological population of same species separated from each other to the point that help to prevent any type of genetic interchange. This type of separation is also known as vicariance, that is a process which has the geographical range of individual species is divided into gap parts by the occurs of the geographical changes of human activity. So, the vicariant population then undergo genotypic as well as phenotypic divergence as they become subjected to different selective pressure. There will be different selective pressures. They independently undergo genetic drift and different mutation arise in the population gene pool. So, you have to remember this point. This is the variance. Vicariance. That is the process which helps in the geographical range. So, speciation in which biological population are physically isolated by extrinsic barrier and evolve intrinsic, that is a genetic reproductive isolation, that is about the sympatric, such that if the barrier break down, individual of the population can no longer interbreed. Two species of the squirrels live in either side of the Grand Canyon. They are the example of allopatric speciation. This is the original population. This is the allopatric, means two geographical area. This is the initial step of separation. Evolution of reproductive isolation, new distinct species will appear. This is the green color. Yes, through this example you can easily understand. This is the initial sample of the fruit flies. This is the all the sample of the fruit flies. They are kept in starch medium and in this maltose medium. They both are carbohydrate. So maltose, it is a basic polysaccharide, it is a basic monosaccharide, and starch is the polysaccharide. So after several generation, what actually will happen, that is the mating preference. There will be mating preferences. So many fruit flies will come from here and some will come from here. So they have two different sources. So sympatric speciation occur when two individual population diverge from an ancestral species from the same geographical area. For example, 200 years ago, the ancestor of apple maggot flies lays their egg only in the hawthorns, but today these flies lay egg on the hawthorns which are native to America and domestic apples which are introduced to America by immigrants and breed. So immigrants, the individuals which are coming into a particular population, the female generally choose to lay their eggs on the type of the fruit they grew up, and the male tend to look for the mates on the type of the fruit they grew up with. So hawthorn flies generally end up mating with other hawthorn flies, and apple flies generally end up mating with other apple flies. This means that gene flow between the parts of the population that mate on different type of fruit is reduced. This host shift from hawthorns to apples may be the first step towards sympatric speciation. In fewer than 200 years, some genetic differences between these two groups of the flies have been evolved. This is the sympatric speciation, where there will be the same geographical area. Sim suggests same. Yes, this is the example of the sympatric speciation. So, in this diagram, you can easily see many varieties in one range become species through adaptation to different aspects of the range. This is the one, only one geographical area, but different species are adapting. Yes, this is a unique type of speciation in which new species are created out of pre-existing species. There are no physical barrier which separate members of an existing species, like in allopatric speciation. Another way of new species are created. Sympatric speciation is rare. It is not so much common in plants than in animals. It happens in plants when due to some error during the reproduction, offspring is produced that contain twice the number of normal chromosomes. A normal cell is diploid since it has two copies of each chromosome, one from each parent, as you all know. But this certain offspring has four copies of each chromosome. Hence, it is called tetraploid. So this process of getting more chromosome than the normal, it is known as polyploidy. I think we have discussed in the genetics module about the mutation. In mutation, I have discussed what is polyploidy. So this is an example of the polyploidy in a cell with a diploid number 6. Yes, this is the graph or the peaks. You can easily understand this is the original population and this is the physical isolation. Due to the some geographical barrier, and this is the reproductive isolation, and this is the speciation. Here also original population, physical isolation, reproductive isolation, and speciation. Means speciation, it is a result of physical isolation or reproductive isolation. So physical isolation, it is the allopatric, and reproductive isolation, it is the sympatric. Through this comparative chart, we can easily understand what exactly the difference between the allopatric and sympatric. So allopatric, as I already told you, that allopatric, there will be geographical barrier. Is geographic isolation needed? Yes, it is mandatory. But what happens in the sympatric? There will be no geographic isolation. No. Major differentiation mechanism here is the natural selection. I will discuss later what exactly the natural selection in this module, evolution only. And what exactly the polyploidy. So here the differentiation mechanism is natural selection, and here is polyploidy. The speed of creation of new species, here is slow, here is fast. Sympatric, because of autopolyploidy is fast and allopolyploidy is slow. This is common in nature. Yes, allopatric is very much common. Sympatric, it is also common in plants. Examples of allopatric are Darwin finches, squirrels in the Grand Canyon, and sympatric, cultivated corn, wheat, and tobacco. This is the ancestral species. And allopatric, as I told, there will be geographical barrier. They are geographically isolated from each other. This is the formation of the new species, and this is the ancestral species. What actually happened in sympatric speciation? This is the ancestral species and they are in the same geographical area. Sympatric means same, and new species will arrive with the ancestral species also. Okay, so these all about the sympatric and allopatric speciation. Later on, I will give a separate video on what exactly the peripatric and parapatric speciation is. Okay, so this video is all about only sympatric and allopatric and some basics of the speciation. I hope you all have understood this video very well. It is very important topic for any competitive exam as well as for your academic. So please, friends, try to share this video, hit the like button, subscribe to my channel and share this video with your friends as more as possible. So I hope we will meet soon. Thank you, friends.